In this part, I want to preview the design approach that we're going to take. Very often it seems as though design begins with some specifications and there's a nice logical serial process until the final design is reached. But design doesn't work that way. We need to have an idea of where we're going and what type of approach we're going to use, and very often that is based on experience. Bootstrapping design, when you haven't got much experience, is always difficult. Here I'm going to give you the preview of the design approach we're going to use, and it is called Design Using the Negative Image Model. Recall that curve B is gamma S for optimum M1. That gamma S shown there is S11 conjugate. So provided that S12 is very small, gamma S, which is equal to gamma in conjugate, is also equal to S11 conjugate because gamma in and S11 will be very, very close. Now what is difficult about this characteristic is that it is rotating in the clockwise direction. Now an element that has a reflection coefficient that is in the top half of the Smith chart will be inductive. But if we had an inductance with a series resistor, we would follow one of these lines. But as we increase in frequency, we will move in the clockwise direction. Now this is a Smith chart, so these are lines of constant reactance. But clearly it is not an inductor itself. So what does this element look like? It is inductive, but it's not an inductor. The answer is that it's a resistor and a negative capacitor in series. So the negative capacitor has that inductive reactance property, but we move in the opposite direction to a positive inductor. Perhaps our input matching network looks like a resistor and a negative capacitor in series. Here is our input network. Here is our negative capacitor. And the resistance, well, that resistance will be just the port impedance here. So it won't be 50 ohms. So we won't have a 50 ohm port. It'll be some other value, which we've got to find. Another way of looking at this problem is that if we look into the input of the transistor, we will see a capacitor. To cancel that capacitance, well, the easiest way to cancel it is to have a negative capacitance with the same value magnitude. That resistance, well, for maximum power transfer, we want this resistance to be the same as the series resistance looking into the transistor. The transistor is absorbing power. Then, once we have designed this input matching network, our simpler design problem, simpler than designing the whole amplifier, our simpler design problem is coming up with a network that has the same input reflection coefficient as our image input matching network. That is a simpler problem. There will still be considerable effort because we've got to synthesize a circuit that has the right characteristic. Now we can extend this problem to include the output matching network. Here is the output matching network. And we find that the output matching network needs to incorporate a negative capacitor in parallel with a negative inductor and a resistance which comes from the port, and again it won't be 50 ohms. Another way of looking at how we arrive at that image network at the output is to imagine what we see looking into our discrete transistor. Our discrete transistor will have bond wire inductance and it will have capacitance. The capacitance we cancel with a negative capacitor in the output matching network. The bond wire inductance we cancel with a negative inductor. And this resistance is the value that we need for maximum power transfer. It's going to be the same value as the output parallel resistance. Now, when we do design, we have to look at the input and output matching networks together, and we need to trade off the characteristics that we're going to get by adjusting the input matching network and adjusting the output matching network. We cannot just do one on their own. When we come up with the optimum circuit with these image models, our design problem reduces considerably to one of designing the input matching network, having the same input reflection coefficient as our negative image model for the input matching network, and similarly for the output.